see God, whom I shall see for myself, and mine eyes shall behold, as not as a stranger. For none of us liveth to himself, and no man dieth to himself. For if we live unto the Lord. And if we die unto the Lord. Whether we live, therefore, or die, we are the Lord's. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Even so saith the Spirit, for they rest from their labors. The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray. O God, whose mercies cannot be numbered, accept our prayers on behalf of thy servant, and grant her an entrance into the land of light and joy in the fellowship of thy saints. Through Jesus Christ, thy only Son, our Lord, who liveth and reigneth with thee in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Therefore, we will not fear, though the earth should change, though the mountains shake in the heart of the sea, though its waters roar and foam, though the mountains tremble with its tumult. There is a river whose streams make glad the city of God, the holy habitation of the Most High. God is in the midst of the city, it shall not be moved. God will help it when the morning dawns. The nations are in an uproar, the kingdoms totter. He utters his voice, and the earth melts. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge. Come behold the works of the Lord. See what desolations he has brought on the earth. He makes wars cease to the end of the earth. He breaks the bow and shatters the spear. He burns the shield with fire. Be still and know that I am God. I am exalted among the nations. I am exalted in the earth. The Lord of hosts is with us. The God of Jacob is our refuge.
Like him, for we will see him as he is.
The word of the Lord.
Believe also in me.
In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going. Thomas said to him, Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way? Jesus said to him, I am the way and the truth and the life. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
May the words of my mouth and the meditation of all our hearts be acceptable unto you, O God, our strength and our Redeemer.
Amen.
On behalf of St. Bartholomew's Church, I extend our deepest condolences for everyone mourning the loss of Joanna. Being new to this congregation, I did not know her well. I think I met her 3 times. But it's clear to me that she was much beloved here and is already deeply missed, and I'm sure she is elsewhere also. Without going into too many details, I wanted to share that I will never forget the first of the couple times I met her. She came to a meeting over some fairly complicated matters and made the point that her primary reason for being there was so that I, a person she had never met before, could have an advocate for his needs. I get the sense that this is just who she was, a person of empathy who cared about her neighbors as much as she did for herself. It came from her grounding herself in Jesus, taking his teachings to heart and imitating his actions with her own. Powerful spirituality begets a caring soul. The other way I can tell she had a strong spiritual resolve is in this service we're participating in right now. In her final months, Joanna planned every part of it, every reading, every song, every little detail. What we're all experiencing today is one of her final labors of love to those who wish to remember her. And it was no small task. Still grieving from the loss of her husband Tom, and no doubt bitter that her remaining years were taken from her too soon, she found the acceptance and the strength to plan for this and other things that would happen after she was gone. It's pretty remarkable, really, when you think about it. So let's look at just one of those passages she picked out for today. Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, but also believe in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, but I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you. And if I go to prepare a place for you, I will come again and take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. That is actually the passage I want for my own memorial service. It's so warm in its presentation of divine intimacy. In this dwelling place, each person who has spent their life longing for closeness and nearness with God finally attains it. Jesus takes them to himself. As Jesus comforts us, saying, do not let your hearts be troubled, I think I can feel Joanna comforting us today with these words, saying, this wonderful dwelling place is where I am, and you can all rest assured that Jesus will take you here someday also. And there is one other thing that I understand from some conversations I had needs to be said about her today. When we were planning for this service, someone asked me if it would be appropriate to include as one of the songs, John Denver's Country Roads Take Me Home. Yes, I know it would be a fantastic sentiment for us all to remember her by singing a song she loved about her old home in West Virginia. Unfortunately, my priestly vows more or less forbid me from leading a congregation and singing a secular song about the misty taste of moonshine. Still, I do think the song has something to teach us for today. I'll explain with a few personal stories. Several years ago, my dad and I were driving to his old hometown in Kentucky to see his mom. We got to the familiar neighborhood of his youth, and even though it wasn't West Virginia, he started singing Country Roads Take Me Home. It just fits. In another story, one of my old college roommates talks me into watching a movie with him. It's a Japanese movie about two children, and in one scene, the little girl teaches the little boy her favorite song. Country Roads Take Me Home. I was confused. Kentucky and West Virginia, there's a certain overlap there. But how would a child from Japan, who's likely never seen the Blue Ridge Mountains, feel so strongly about that song? The question was answered about a week later when I went with some friends to a summer festival in the park. We stopped to listen to a band, and just after we got there, they started playing that same song we've been talking about. And of course, as you know, the whole crowd is singing along. And one of the guys in this group had just arrived in the U.S. from Germany, and I was surprised to see that he knew all the words. I asked him about it, and he said, "Oh, this is a very popular song in Germany." And I said, "Really?" And he said, "Yes. Everybody relates to the feeling of going home." And that made me get it. Whether you're from West Virginia, or Cleveland, or Kentucky, or Japan, or Germany, or anywhere else, you know that almost home, almost heaven feeling of going back where you came from. The final message from Joanna, then, I think, is this. She is home. There is a spot in God's eternal dwelling place where Jesus went long ago to prepare just for her. It is where she was always supposed to be, and she's there now, enjoying the warmth and presence of her Creator. And all the ways she planned for this day, what she wants everyone to know most, is that she is in the peace in her heavenly home. Amen.
Amen.
Let's continue standing as we are able, affirming our faith in the Word of the Apostles. I believe in God. Have our consummation bliss in thy eternal and everlasting glory.
and with blessed Bartholomew and all the saints to receive the crown of life which thou hast promised to all who share in the victory of thy Son, Jesus Christ, who liveth and reigneth with thee and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you.
Son to share our union, to live and die as one of us, to reconcile us to you, the God and Father of all. He stretched out his arms upon the cross and offered himself in obedience to your will, a perfect sacrifice for the whole world. On the night he was handed over to suffering and death, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread. And when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine. And when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, we proclaim the mystery of faith.
Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again.
We celebrate the memorial of our redemption, O Father, in this sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Recalling his death, resurrection, and ascension, we offer you these gifts. Sanctify them by your Holy Spirit to be with your people in the body and blood of your Son, the holy food and drink of new and unending life in him. Sanctify us also, that we may faithfully receive this holy sacrament and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. And in the last day, bring us with all your saints into the joy of your eternal kingdom. All this we ask through your Son, Jesus Christ, by him and with him and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever.
Thank you.
this last part of the prayer over Joanna's remains. Everyone the Father gives to me will come to me.
I will never turn away anyone who believes in me.
He who raised Jesus from the dead will also give new life to our mortal bodies. My heart, therefore, is glad, and my spirit rejoices.
My body also shall rest in hope.
You will show me the path of life.
In your presence there is fullness of joy, and in your right hand are pleasures forevermore.
Remembering our beloved sister Joanna, alleluia, alleluia, let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.